Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Gettysburg College's Majestic Theater. We'd like to remind you that the use of flash photography or recording devices of any kind is strictly prohibited. If you have gum or candy, now would be the time to unwrap it. And why not share some with your neighbor? If you have a cell phone or beeper, now would be the time to turn it off. Unless, of course, you have Sprint. You don't get reception with Sprint anyway, so it really doesn't matter. We invite you now to sit back, relax, and enjoy the 2014 Totem Pole Playhouse Awards. Your hosts for this evening are...
Good evening, I'm Fred Snyder, columnist for the Gettysburg Times.
And I'm Rowan Joseph, producing artistic director of Totem Pole Playhouse. This for the students, Fred. We lucked out already.
Is this why you told me to wear black so we don't look so fat?
No, yes, it was fading into the background. That's what black is. Thanks for coming out tonight. This is the first of hopefully many annual, and I'm sure it will be, annual Totem Pole Playhouse Awards. The whole focus this evening, just so you understand, it's going to be very loose, very easygoing. The focus is 100% on the students. Fred and I will keep our banter down pretty much to a minimum as best we can. The presenters will be making brief remarks. Each of the winners is allotted a short amount of time to accept their award and thank their other nominees and their schools and directors. When the presenters will be coming up this staircase. The students who win can come up this staircase over here if they're in the audience, and you'll also exit, the students will exit off this way as well. And when we have production numbers, there are going to be a lot of students getting up and walking around. We'll kind of allow for that. It's, as I said, it's going to be a very loose and informal evening. The entertainment this evening is certainly not going to be Fred and I.
No, but could you run that down again?
The entertainment is going to be the students this evening. Starting off, can we bring up the house lights for the whole theater? I'd like to introduce each of the high schools and ask each of them to stand up before we even get started and take a bow for the wonderful job they did this year and the hard work they put in. Waynesboro High School. Head on backstage, Waynesboro, you're the opening member for the show. That all of the schools will be hearing the other schools. We had rehearsal all day today. We started at 3 o'clock. We went through, did all of the production numbers. There are 11 of them. We did the best soloists, male and female. There are 5 of each of those, and the 5 duets. Everything went really well. But the schools didn't see each other perform, so they're seeing it for the first time tonight as well. Our second school that we're introducing is...
Where's Chambersburg?
So as you can see, there's going to be a lot of energy in the house tonight. We have a lot of fun ahead of us. We have a lot of awards to give out. And sit back, relax, enjoy the evening. We're just going to go from one to the other. Our first production number is with Waynesboro High School from Damn Yankees. And the number is 6 months out of every year. Waynesboro High School.
Solid.
someone says to me, well, they need a little time to get off, so why don't you banter a little bit? So I'm going to banter. Isn't it great that theater arts and music is alive and well? I think oftentimes we hear about all the great things that happen in sports, but hey, sit back and relax and enjoy tonight. Next up, we have Chambersburg High School. They're ready. We're going to wait just a sec or so.
I said, I thought you said to dance. I was expecting a little...
Oh, you said banner. I thought you said dance.
Oh, whatever fill in. Whatever fills in.
We had a traffic jam over here.
We're going to have a lot of traffic jams tonight. You'll get used to that, folks. There are a lot of students and a lot of shows with a lot of production numbers. So as soon as they take their seats, I think we are...
Are we ready?
Moving along? I believe that we are.
All right, once again, Chambersburg High School, Oh Bless the Lord from Godspell.
Thank you.
we got our first presentation of the evening. Want to bring up our first award presenter, Harry Hartman, who is the publisher of the New Gettysburg Times. And he hates it when I call him the boss, but hurry, boss, get up here. See, tonight I can move the boss along. Harry will present the award for outstanding performance by an actress in a supporting role. Harry Hartman.
Outstanding performance by an actress in a supporting role. First nominee, Jenna Temple, Kim McAfee, Bye Bye Birdie, Gettysburg Area High School. Alexis Anderson, Hope Harcourt, Anything Goes, Littlestown High School. Caitlin Malott, Betty Rizzo, Grease, McConnellsburg High School. Kate Kistler, Paulette, Legally Blonde, Mercersbury Academy. And Taylor Davis, Meg Boyd, Damn Yankees, Waynesboro Area Senior High School. Outstanding performance by an actress in supporting role, Taylor Davis.
Here this evening, Gary Marshall, who's a very well-known film and television director. Gary directed Pretty Woman and Feature happy days for her. Thank you, Gary Marshall. If you're watching from California, if not, that's okay. So if you hear me do it, Gary Marshall, I said, Gary, thanks for the awards. I basically called him, this is costing us an arm and a leg, and I only have two of each. You know? And he said, I'll send you some money, I'll buy the awards. Send me the bill. Just send the bill to Heather, I'll pay for the trophies. So I should have probably gotten your 5-foot trophies, but. He said, the only thing is, you gotta tell the kids who win. They gotta go out and buy a lot of Princess Diaries DVDs now so I can pay for the awards. Thank you, Gary Marshall. Our next presenter is the publisher of the Record Herald newspaper in Waynesboro for 18 years, the senior group publisher for Gatehouse Media, Pat Patterson, here to present the award for best outstanding performance by an actor in a supporting role.
Thank you. What a great start to what's going to be a super evening. Outstanding performance by an actor in a supporting role. Matt Meckley, Nicely Johnson, Guys and Dolls from Bermudian Springs High School. Austin, Godspell, from Chambersburg Area High School. Brandon Purnell, Chad Danford, High School Musical, Forbes Road Junior. McKinley Anderson, Elisha Whitney, Anything Goes, New Oxford High School. Joe Hardy, Dan Yankees, Waynesboro Area Senior High School. It's exciting. And the winner for outstanding performance by an actor in a supporting role, Austin Widman.
Us. Julie, are you here? Here's Julie. All righty. In addition, as you probably gathered from what I just said, in addition to the 11 production numbers, we will hear performances tonight from the best female soloist, or the outstanding female soloist, the outstanding male soloist. We also are going to hear 5 outstanding duets. And the first of those is coming up right now. It's from Bermudian Springs. It's the song Guys and Dolls from the musical Guys and Dolls. And here to sing it are Matt Meckley and Fisher Selby.
Fight at the Roxy, Picture Battle Minnesota Mantle, Mo with the Mississippi Woman that he sacrifices everything and moves all the way to Biloxi. That's what's playing at the Roxy.
What's in the daily news? I'll tell you what's in the daily news. Story about a guy who bought his wife a small ruby with what otherwise would have been his union dues. That's what's in the daily news.
What's happening all over? I'll tell you what's happening all over. Guy sitting home by his television set who once used to be something of a rover. That's what's happening all over. Love is the thing that has linked them. And it looks like Nathan's just another victim. Yes, sir!
When you see a guy reach the stars in the sky, you can bet that he's doing it for some doll.
When you spot a John waiting out in the rain, chances are he's insane, is only a job can be for a chain.
When you meet a gent paying all kinds of rent for a flat that can flatten the Taj Mahal.
Call it sad, call it funny, but it's better than even money that the guy's only doing it for some dough. When you see a Joe saving half of his dough, you can bet they'll be making it for some dough.
When a bum buys wine like a bum can't afford, it just seems that the bum is under the thumb of some little broad.
When you need a mug lately out of the jug, and you still lift and platinum cold the wrong, call it hell, call it heaven, it's a probable 12 to 7 that the guy's only doing it for some dough. When you see a sport and his cash has run short, make a bet that he's banking it for some dough.
When a guy wears tails with a frugly white, who the hell do you think he's tickling pink on Saturday night?
When a lazy slug takes a good steady job, and he smells from Vitalis and Barbasol.
Call it dumb, call it clever, how can you give us forever that the guy's only doing it for some dough?
I think I'm supposed to have a partner on this introduction.
Turn my mic. Oh, there it is. There it is. His mouth's so big he doesn't need a mic. I understand that. Well, we have three production numbers in a row coming up.
Yeah, Bye Bye Birdie. Is that a pretty...
One of them is from Bye Bye Birdie. The second one is from...
Bye Bye Birdie?
Oh, and the third one would be from...
What?
Bye Bye Birdie.
Is that a popular...
It must be very popular. We would actually, we're going to write to the publishers and see if we can get a percentage for all the money they made out of this area on Bye Bye Birdie this year. They were all terrific productions, all very different. Basically, the way the awards work is there's a jury of five different evaluators. They're not judges, they evaluate, and then they judge. Who are we trying to kid? And I am one of them. I saw all 11 shows, including all three Bye Bye Birdies. And I would announce with someone else, and then the other people go on nights. I'm announced.
I see. Yes. A lot of birds, huh?
Yep. A lot of birds sitting out in that audience, taking notes and watching things. So we're going to have three back-to-back production numbers from Fred, from Bye Bye Birdie, and Fred?
All right. How about James Buchanan High School, The Telephone Hour from Bye Bye Birdie.
Tell me quick, or will you go and keep? Hi, Margie. kiss this great.
Hello, Mrs. Miller, this is Harvey Johnson. Can I speak to Deborah Sue?
Hi, Hugo. Hi, stupid. What you wanna go get me?
Come together in the same group, and so I had met him earlier, was introduced to him, and to be, okay, well, I have to say something, so I said, so, Paul, are you enjoying the party? And he said, I rented a limo for this. I was like, wow, it's like my own Hollywood Square remark. That's pretty cool. Coming up, our next number from Bye Bye Birdie is A Lot of Living to Do, and it's going to be performed by our local high school here, Gettysburg High School. A Lot of Living to Do.
Thank you.
You know, this is the first year, and Merwin's doing a great job. I don't know where he put all this together. I mean, a lot of people were involved with it. Mr. Majestic, Jeffrey Gable, but I'm going to suggest the traffic lights on this thing next year. Get a moving on the right, get a moving on the left. Look at this. Greencastle and from high school, and their selection from Bye Bye Birdie, Healthy Normal American Boy. Is that an oxymoron?
In addition to doing the awards, Totem Pole this year has a lot of changes. I'm one of them. I'm the new producing artistic director there. I'm very happy to be at Totem Pole. I moved to Fayetteville. I live here. I'm your neighbor, so look out. I'm a registered actor living in your community and amongst you, so be aware of that. Our next presenter, we've roped into getting involved on the other side of the mountain. I have to talk to people from Gettysburg about this mountain that I keep hearing about when I moved here. So, you know, in Gettysburg, I mean, it's, you know, they don't like going over the mountain. I'm thinking, it's not so bad. I mean, I drove it, I went to the top. If you live in Gettysburg, if you go to the top and you put your car in neutral, you can drift right into the parking lot at Totem Pole. So, it's not so bad. And you people in McConnellsburg, do me a favor. Talk to some of these people in Gettysburg about what a mountain is. Our next presenter, in addition to being the president of Gettysburg Tours, has also been kind enough to join Totem Pole this year in a very important sponsorship aimed directly at that mountain, Gettysburg. It's called the Totem Pole Trolley. Every Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night, free of charge, Totem Pole, in association or in sponsorship with the well-spanned Gettysburg Hospital, has joined together with Gettysburg Tours, and we will have a trolley that will run free of charge every Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night for anyone over here in Gettysburg who buys a ticket to see the show over at Totem Pole. We will give you the free ride and take you over that mountain and bring you back safely. That's awesome. Absolutely free. I think it's a wonderful thing, especially for senior citizens who are apprehensive of driving at night. Now they can get on the trolley. You'll be reading about it in the newspaper this week. It's we're picking up the tour center. I know that we're also picking up in front of the Gettysburg Hotel. There'll be three different stops. You'll be hearing a lot more about it. The only word, the only thing you really need to remember is, it's free! Free's good, huh? Helping us to be able to afford to make that free is Max Felty, the president of Gettysburg Tours. Max is going to be coming up and he's presenting our next award of the evening, which is for the outstanding performance by a featured female ensemble member. And let me just explain while he's on his way up here what a featured ensemble member means. A featured ensemble member basically is what I end up doing in movies. I was in the campaign last year with Will Ferrell and Zach Galifianakis and I played reporter Gary. I was in Grudge Match earlier this year with Sylvester Stallone and Robert De Niro playing Waiter with Telephone. That's what it said. Waiter with Telephone. That's an ensemble feature player. There's an expression in show business, there are no small roles, only small actors. There are a lot of small roles, and they're a lot of fun to play, and you win awards doing them sometimes. So let's hear for small roles. Present the award for outstanding female ensemble member.
Just want to say congratulations to all of the very talented nominees out there. So here we go for the award for outstanding performance by a featured female ensemble member. Kylie Davis for Mimi and Guys and Dolls, Bermudian Springs High School. Emily Baker for Ursula Merkel and Bye Bye Birdie, Gettysburg Area High School. Michaela Iverson for Ursula Merkel and Bye Bye Birdie, James Buchanan High School. Sarah Hollinshead for Patty Simcox and Greece, McConnellsburg High School. Emily Mitchell for Vivian and Legally Blonde, Mercersburg Academy. And tonight's winner for outstanding performance by a featured female ensemble member is Emily Baker.
My name is Greg Trax, and I'm the dramatic director at Gettysburg Area High School for their musical program. Unfortunately, Ms. Baker couldn't be here this evening, but I humbly accept this award on her behalf. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Did I blow the speaker? No, I didn't. Max, about that job. You know, he runs the tour company. I always wanted to... Ladies and gentlemen, we're now passing the Jenny Wade House. I'll be around to see you. Our fourth award presenter tonight is Katie Pettiford. And Katie is assistant metro editor for the Hanover Evening Sun newspaper. She will present the award for outstanding performance by a featured male ensemble member.
Congratulations to everyone who was nominated. I'm going to present the award for outstanding performance for a featured male ensemble member, and the nominees are Michael Jose, Harry the Horse, Guys and Dolls, Remedian Springs Area Theater. Stephen Hoffman, Jack Scott, High School Musical, Forbes Road Junior Senior High School. Johnny Casino, Greece, McConnellsburg High School. James Arthur, Kyle, Legally Blonde, Mercenersburg Academy. Bill Batista, Smokey, Damn Yankees, Waynesboro Area. And the winner for outstanding performance by a featured male ensemble member is James Reifert.
So thank you very much. Thank you very much for inviting us to this award show this evening. I hope everybody has a great evening. Thank you very much.
I tell you, we got a lot of talent in this house tonight. I'd like to introduce the second best duet nominee, Claire Martin and Ben Dennis. They're going to perform Two Lost Souls from Damn Yankees. Claire Martin and Ben Dennis for Lincoln Park.
Two lost souls on a highway of hearts, we enter. We got each other. Two hot ships on a stormy sea. One with no sail and one with no rudder.
Studios for taking the pictures this evening. Thank you very much. We appreciate it. Thank you for all of you. All of you by, your parents goodbye, your grandparents in Florida goodbye, and your other grandparents in Nebraska goodbye. They'll be online. You'll be able to find out where those are at and how that happens. By any chance, do we have any people in the audience? And if so, would you kind of raise your hand for me? Anyone between the age of 16 and 22 here tonight? A lot. That's good. That's good because I have some really great news for anybody who is between the age of 16 and 22 and lives anywhere near Totem Pole Playhouse. Because in addition to these awards, one of the things that Totem Pole feels strongly about is not only nurturing our local talent by presenting these awards, but also nurturing their performances by allowing them greater access to some other performers that are coming in from Hollywood, from New York and Broadway, from Nashville. And the best way that we thought that we could do that was every single performance this year at Totem Pole Playhouse, 1/2 hour before the curtain, any ticket which is not sold will go on sale that half hour for $10 to anyone between the age of 16 and 22 years old. Show cheaper than a movie. You can bring a date for $20, be sitting in $100 seats. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. I think that would impress a girl or a guy, depending upon who's paying. I don't want to be sexist or whatever. So come out, see the show, see them a couple times. And because Totem Pole Playhouse is in Caledonia State Park, which is sort of in the middle of nowhere, it's between Chambersburg and Gettysburg, as you know, and of course we have this mountain that some people are afraid of coming over. And we have the real mountain in the other direction that people should be afraid of coming over. I'm afraid of that one. You can actually phone Totem Pole Playhouse box office and find out if there are going to be seats available for that performance coming up. And they'll let you know ahead of time because we don't want you wasting your time coming out there and standing in line if we're going to be sold out, which I think we will be on occasion, hopefully. So, but there'll be plenty of opportunities. So all summer long, I hope that you will come out for our matinees, which are Tuesday, Wednesday, Saturdays, and Sundays, and our evening performances, which are Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday nights. So we wanted to avail you of that opportunity. You'll be hearing me talk about it a lot more probably tonight. Next, our category coming up for performance are the best female outstanding. We keep saying best because we're just sort of used to that. They're both the best and they're outstanding. All of the nominees, everything we've seen tonight is outstanding, don't you think? I'm fortunate enough to get to see all 11 schools. It was just terrific. And keep in mind, too, they had a lot of snow to deal with, a lot of days off, a lot of other things to deal with. And the people who do plays work just as hard as the people who are out rehearsing for, or practicing, rather, for baseball and football and the other sports. These are five terrific female soloists. I'm going to introduce each one of them and then they will get up and perform their songs. Claire Martin, Whatever Lola Wants, Lola Gets, from Dan Yankee's Waynesboro High School. She was the one with the microphone and the quick change I had to fill in for. I hope I did okay for you there, Claire. Caitlin Crawford, Adelaide's LeBanc Guys and Dolls, Bermudian Springs High School. Jenna Temple, How Lovely to Be a Woman, from Bye Bye Birdie, Gettysburg. Also from Bye Bye Birdie, Sierra Kelly will be singing An English Teacher. She was in James Buchanan's. Our final soloist performance this evening will be by Brittany Blank. I Get a Kick Out of You, from Anything Goes, New Oxford High School. The outstanding female soloist this season.
Thank you. psychosomatic symptoms, difficult to endure, affecting the upper respiratory tract. In other words, just from waiting around for that clean little band of fall, a person can develop a cold. You can spray wherever you pick in a streptococcal lung. You can give her a shot or whatever she's got, but it just won't work. If she's tired of getting the fish eye from the hotel bar, a person can develop a cold. It's Tia, the female remaining single, just in the legal sense, shows a neurotic tendency. See note. Note! Chronic organic symptoms, toxic or hypertense, involving the eye, the ear, and the nose and throat. In other words, just from worrying whether the wedding is on or off, a person can develop a cough. You can feed her all day with the vitamin A and the bromophys, but the medicine never gets anywhere near where the trouble is. And she's getting a kind of a neighbor's oven and they may miss a person.
Be a woman, the wait was well worthwhile. Bernie's going into the army. He's going in the army is the best thing he could do. Now you're free to start to do what you wanted to. Albert, Albert, Albert. I remember how you told me I should trust you for a year. It would just be for a year, but it's 8 years, Albert. 8 long years, Albert. It was only a sideline, that's what you said. You just needed some money, that's what you said. You were going to college and get ahead. Instead of being a music business bum, you were going to NYU and become an English teacher. And furthermore, you wrote poetry in the NYU yearbook under Al Peterson's favorite piece of literature. Do you know what it said? Little Women. An English teacher, an English teacher. If only you'd been an English teacher, we'd have a little apartment in Queens. You'd get a summer vacation, and we would know what life means. A man who's got his master's is really someone. How proud I'd be if you had become one. It could have been such a wonderful life. I could have been Mrs. Peterson, Mrs. Albert Peterson, Mrs. Phi Beta Kappa Peterson, the English teacher's wife.
Much too sad to be told, but practically everything leaves me totally cold. The only exception I know is the case when I'm out on a quiet spree, fighting vainly the old and weak, and I suddenly turn and see your fabulous face. I get no kick from champagne. Mere alcohol doesn't thrill me at all. But tell me, why should it be true that I get a kick out of you? Some dig that perfume from Spain. I'm sure that if I
amazing talent, just wonderful talent. While the women are exiting that way, we were going to actually ask the male soloists if they would exit that way and go backstage and get ready for their performance. Fun night, isn't it?
It's
pretty cool. We're on schedule here. What's that? Who would have thought it? There's a gentleman here, Jeffrey Gable, who is just such a gift to this community, in my opinion, and I'm sure yours as well. He's the executive director here at Gettysburg College's Majestic Theater. He's someone who's one of the first friends I made when I came to town. I knew him before I came here because I remember very early on having to give a curtain speech and going online and thinking, I have no idea how you give a speech before a show. And I found a terrific article by Jeffrey that gave me a great example of exactly how you do that. I'm sure Jeffrey's very happy he doesn't have to vote for these awards. I'm sure he's even happier that he gets to give out the award for Outstanding Female Solo Vocal Performance. Ladies and gentlemen, Jeffrey Gable.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome on behalf of Gettysburg College to the Majestic Theater, the grandest small town theater in America. In nearly continuous operation since November 14, 1925, we have just completed our 88th season. On our 80th birthday, November 14th, 2005, after a $16.5 million renovation, this theater and this very stage where all you young performers are treading tonight has been blessed and trod before you by stars from all around the world. So you're performing on hallowed stage tonight. Just two I want to mention on that 80th birthday reopening gala, we had a true living legend of the Broadway stage here, Elaine Stritch. And she was celebrating her 80th birthday that year, and she brought down the house, and she just retired last year. And then a few years later, we had the famous, probably the finest American actor of our generation, who has been touring for over 55 years in the brilliant one-man show, Mark Twain Tonight. Hal Holbrook was on the stage. And he, this year, is 88 years old and still touring as Mark Twain. So you're on great company on this stage tonight. So the reward tonight is for the outstanding female solo vocal performances, and you just heard them all. Caitlin Crawford, Adelaide's Lament, Guys and Dolls, Bermudian Springs High School. Jenna Tempa, How Lovely to Be a Woman, from Bye Bye Birdie, Gettysburg Area High School. Sierra Kelly, an English teacher, Bye Bye Birdie, James Buchanan High School. Brittany Blank, I Get a Kick Out of You, Anything Goes, New Oxford High School. And finally, Claire Martin, Whatever Lola Wants, Lola Gets, from Damn Yankees, Waynesboro Area Senior High School. Oh, it's so thrilling here tonight. And the outstanding female solo performance goes to Brittany.
expecting this. And I just want to thank all the people in my cast, of course, because they're great. And oh my gosh, so much talent here tonight. I'm so blessed. I'm so blessed to be here with everybody. And I just love everybody behind stage, and we were talking, and I just love everybody so much. And I want to say a special thanks to my best friend, Abby Britton, because I don't think I could have gotten through the show without her. You're going to cry. I love her so much. I don't think my mom and my dad. What is it? Okay, bye.
It had to be tough figuring out who the winner
is. Very tough. I mean, in a lot of these instances, here we go. In a lot of these instances, the difference in votes are just fractions, literally fractions. Not 1 or 2 points, but an eighth of a point, a quarter of a point. It's really tough. And as you can see, we have some wonderful talent in this area. I hope everyone, one of the things that will be a result of the Totem Pole Awards would be everyone going to their high school musicals and supporting them and supporting these terrific kids who perform. Coming up, we have two more production numbers. The first one is going to be from Littlestown High School, Anything Goes, from the musical Anything Goes.
And then, community in high school, sit down, you're rocking the boat from Guys and Donald.
Well, back to back.
Now only for letter words, writing prose.
I tell you, we got a lot of great entertainment here tonight. Your reunion spring high school and their production from Guys and Dolls. Sit down, you're rocking a boat.
Anything goes with Little Towns just did. There's a whole shift behind them. They're all different levels and all different places and nooks and crannies. And so they're at a little bit of a disadvantage, candidly, here. The rule of thumb that I told all the directors was they had no scenery, but the props were all right. So Aaron, Lola, to you, you're just a prop, just so you know. I'm sorry, you're not pretty scenery. You're a prop. You might want to talk to them about that. I'm just kidding. So the production numbers, isn't it amazing what they're doing up here with these production numbers? Just astounding. I also want to take a minute to say two things. One, that we are actually on schedule and on time. And two, the reason for that is Chad Allen Carr, who is the executive director and the artistic director at the Gettysburg Community Theater, who's running everything backstage. He is the Mussolini of the Totem Pole Awards, keeping the trains running on time and doing an amazing job. We're very grateful to Chad. Next up, we have some more awards to hand out. The first award that we're going to be giving away in these next three is for the outstanding performance by a featured dancer. So many amazing different dancers this evening. And to give the award out is an amazing woman who is sort of the at this point, she's the patron saint of Totem Pole Playhouse. Currently, she's responsible for everything, and always has been, but right now her main focus is on advertising and marketing and public relations, so we have her to thank for all of the press you've seen for the Totem Pole Awards, all of the press you're going to be seeing, and everything that's been going on there. And I have her to thank for really helping me, you know, find my feet at Totem Pole. I basically, when I took the job, there were two people that I said I needed to have there. They were Sue McMurtry and Chris Russo. Daphne Blaine, I didn't realize at the time how sunk I would have been. Thank God she came along with the other two. It was a package deal, and it's the greatest package I've ever had delivered to me in my life. I am very happy to introduce my friend and the saint, really, of Totem Pole Playhouse, Sue McMurtry.
Tonight is a dream come true. In my 28 years, my most favorite shows that we do are musicals. And you will find me at Totem Pole hanging out in the rehearsal hall when they are rehearsing musicals. So in my 28 years, I have enjoyed more than 30 musicals. And I find myself going about the theater singing or humming songs from all the shows. So thank you to all the high schools tonight. You're bringing back lots of wonderful memories for me. And congratulations to all of you. Tonight, outstanding performance by a featured dancer. The nominees are Kylie Davis, Runyon Land, Guys and Dolls, Bermudian Springs High School. Kelly Briner, Spanish Rose, Bye Bye Birdie, Gettysburg Area High School. Eliza Borromeo, Take Me Back to Manhattan, Anything Goes, Littlestown High School. James Griffith, Bend and Snap, Legally Blonde, Mercersburg Academy. Brittany Blank, Blow, Gabriel Blow, Anything Goes, New Oxford High School. I always wondered what it felt like on the Oscars. And the winner is, for outstanding performance by a featured dancer, Kylie Davis.
Especially Ms. Jones for the wonderful choreography, and Matt Carlson, my director, for even casting for the part and everything. So thank you, everyone, and I could not be here without you guys. Thanks.
And we're going to have another presenter, this time for outstanding small ensemble performance. I'd like to bring to the stage Randy File. Randy File is chairman of the Adams County Commissioners. Randy?
Well, my good friend Dana Witt asked me to, or invited me to be a presenter tonight. I had no idea what I was getting into. But I just want to say this is an amazing evening, and we have amazing talent in this community. So great job. I also wanted to let you know, if you can keep a secret, that being county commissioner isn't always this much fun as we're having this evening. As I was driving in, I thought to myself, I put out an informational blurb every 2 weeks to about 400 or 500 county staff and many members of the community, and it goes something like this. It always ends this way. It says, now get out there and experience and enjoy all the historical, recreational, natural, and cultural opportunities that beautiful Adams County, Franklin County, and Fulton County have to offer. So I just want to compliment you all for listening so well and coming out tonight to this great cultural event. For outstanding small ensemble performance, the first nominee is Fugue for Tin Horns from Guys and Dolls, Bermudian Springs High School. The second nominee is Baby Talk to Me from Bye Bye Birdie, Gettysburg Area High School. The next nominee is Friendship from Anything Goes, Littlestown High School. Up next is Grease Lightning from Grease, McConnellsburg High School. And the last nominee is Shoeless Joe from Hannibal Mo from Damn Yankees, Waynesboro Area Senior High School.
Individual award for that performance goes to the school, and it'll be in the trophy case, and those three guys can bring their kids by later and say,
hey, your old man won that. You for Tin Horns.
And then you can sing a couple choruses, and the kids will just shake their heads. So that's something to look forward to. Our next presenter is another mainstay of Totem Pole, a former chairman of the board, member of the board for 16 years, a wonderful friend to me also. The support that I've gotten at Totem Pole has just been terrific. I came from Los Angeles and moved here because the thing that really, really struck me about Totem Pole Playhouse was how giving the community has been for the past 64 years to Totem Pole. I don't know that I've ever seen a community that supported a theater the way Totem Pole has been supported, year after year after year after year. And because I've been so moved by that, very, very early on, I decided that my goal, my mission, my time at Totem Pole will be 100% dedicated to thanking that community and returning the favor in every way I can And this is the first way that we've come up with doing that, the Totem Pole Awards. So thank you for coming out tonight. Thanks for participating. It's going to be a wonderful annual event. It's been great each year. You've been out. Now you can go see all the different high schools and you can say, I would have voted for them. Oh, they should have. So it's a great thing. I want to introduce our next presenter who will be presenting the award for Outstanding Musical Chorus. Again, former president of the board of Totem Pole Playhouse and 16-year member of the board, Elise Overcash. Elise?
Thank you. I feel a kindred spirit with all of these young people here and for all of us in this audience who acted in high school plays. We know the energy, enthusiasm, and shaking nerves that all of them feel. And I want to thank them because they bring back the joy that I felt in performing. And so as I read these nominees, I thank you for giving me joy. For Outstanding Musical Chorus, Guys and Dolls, Bermudian Springs High School. Godspell, Chambersburg Area Senior High School. Anything Goes, Littlestown High School. Grease, McConnellsville High School. Yankees from Waynesboro Area Senior High School. These are really tough to open. And the award for Outstanding Musical Chorus goes to Anything Goes.
Sarah Steele, by my side, from Godspell, Chambersburg Area Senior High School.
Can you take me with you?
17, maybe 18 years. Before I started writing for the Gettysburg Times, I had a radio show in Gettysburg. And every time Totem Pole had a production during their season, I would bring in a cast of the actors and actresses, and they would actually do a scene on the radio. No, it wasn't like having a mime on the radio. They would actually do a scene from their play or production. So it was easy for me to say tonight, it was a pleasure to be invited. And I thank Rowan Joseph, the new artistic director at Totem Pole Playhouse, for inviting me. Next up, gosh, I almost lost my place. Well, we heard from the ladies, and now we're gonna hear from the best male soloists. Now they're going to bring their chairs out. I'm going to introduce them individually. I'll tell you what, you guys sit down, and then when I call your name, you stand up and yeah, you can do your thing. Matt Beckley, sit down, you're rocking the boat, guys and gals. Next up, we have Grant Sanders. Put on a happy face from Bye Bye Birdie. Cody Parson, those magic changes from Greece. How about Drew Becker, easy to love from Anything Goes. Ben Dennis, those were the good old days from Damn Yankees, Waynesboro, Maryland. we're going to start with you.
Sorry, folks, but let me explain what happened here. I'm back here. Turn my mic on. Matt already sang Sit Down, You're Rocking the Boat. He did a brilliant job. You saw it in the production number. Matt, take another bow. I didn't want you to think this guy's really the devil here, and yet they said, sit down, you're out of the boat. So the whole idea was that Matt was going to, you know, stand up and everyone's going to say, sit down, you're rocking the boat, because they already sang it. So he sang that, so we're actually going to start with Grant. Put on a happy face. Gettysburg High School, Bye Bye Birdie.
Thank you. G7, what's that playing on the radio? Why do I stir swaying to and fro? I have never heard that song before. But if I don't hear it anymore, it's still familiar to me, sends a thrill right through me, cause those chords remind me of the night that I first fell in love to. Those magic changes, my heart arranges a melody that's never the same, a melody that's calling my name and makes you please come back to me. Please return to me. Don't go away again. Oh, make them play again the music I wanna hear as once again you whisper in my ear. Oh, my darling, I'll be waiting by the radio. You'll come back to me someday, I know. Been so lonesome since our last goodbye, but I'm singing as I cry, I while the bass is sounding, while the drums are pounding, beating up my broken, rise to first place on the charts. My heart arranges, oh, those magic changes, oh.
How we feel.
thrive in a cottage for two, or even three, four, or five. So try to see your future with me, 'cause you'd be all so I'm
be another situation where I'm sure our presenter's happy that they didn't have to vote, they just get to present. You can tell the committee had their hands full. In a great way, in a wonderful way. To present the award for Outstanding Male Solo Vocal Performance is the president of the board of the directors, and my boss, Dana Witt.
Thank you. Well, I am very proud to be president of the board of directors of Totem Pole Playhouse, but I don't think I've ever been prouder than this night when we can celebrate the wonderful talent that is in our schools. And congratulations to all of you. And I would like to see into the future and maybe see which of these young people will find their way to a professional stage, hopefully Totem Pole Playhouse or another one. And one of them just may be the nominee, one of the nominees for Outstanding Male Solo Vocal Performance. And again, Matt Meckley, Sit Down, You Rock in the Boat, from Guys and Dolls at Bermudian Springs High School. Grant Sanders, Put on a Happy Face from Bye Bye Birdie at Gettysburg High School. Cody Parson, Those Magic Changes from Greece, McConnellsburg High School. Drew Becker, Easy to Love, Anything Goes, New Oxford High School. Ben Dennis, Those Were the Good Old Days, from Damn Yankees at Waynesboro Area Senior High School. And I borrowed my husband's penknife to open the envelope. And tonight, the award for Outstanding Male Solo Vocal Performance goes to Drew Becker.
Well, thank you so much. I could honestly not be more honored to be in such a, and to be, and to be in a category with such amazing guys. Like, they all blew my mind away. Every single buddy in this category was absolutely amazing. And I just want to thank my cast for making my senior year one absolutely special, and my parents for supporting me in musical theater and supporting me in the arts and everything. And so yes, thank you so much.
So much talent, and we've got more to come for you, ladies and gentlemen. Right now, I'd like to introduce the fourth best duet nominee, Brittany Blank and Drew Becker. From Anything Goes, New Oxford High School.
Yeah.
gifted humans like Vincent Humans might think that your song is bad, but I got a notion, I'll second the motion, cause this is what I'm going to add. You're the top, you're Mahatma Gandhi, you're the top, you're Napoleon Bradley, you're the purple light of a summer night in Spain, you're the National Gallior, Gargoyle Salior, cellophane. You're sublime, you're a turkey dinner, you're the tie of an early winter. I'm a toy balloon that's fate soon to pop, but if maybe I'm the bottom, you're the top.
You're the top, you're an arrow collar, you're the top, you're a Coolidge dollar, you're the infantry of the feet of Radis Smith. You're an audio drama,
you're Whistler's mama,
you're a cabin band.
You're a rose, you're Inferno's Dante,
you're the nose of the great Dorante.
You're a dancing Polly, you're the top. You're a hot tamale, you're an egg beautifully too to be. You're Botticelli, you're Keats,
you're Stein,
you're Ovaltine.
You're a moon,
you're the dim upholder, you're the moon. Over May West's shoulder, I'm the nominee of the GOP.
Oh, God!
But baby, I'm the bottom, you're the top.
You're the top, you're a log of salad. You're the top, you're a Berlin ballad. You're the boats that glide on the sleepy side of the sea. You're an old Dutch master.
You made me aster.
It was going to be good, didn't we, huh? All right, good, right? Next up, the eighth of our 11 production numbers from McConnellsburg High School, Born to Hand Jive from Greece.
Woo!
Nice job. Grease. I think I saw that somewhere listed for next year at Totem Pole Playhouse as the last play of our season next year. Big preview there, I guess, of that. Our next production number, these folks, God bless them, came, I think they're about an hour and a half away, if I'm right. Forbes Road Senior Junior High School Musical, doing the number Start of Something New. Forbes Road Senior Junior High School.
I never opened my heart.
You know, you see all the great performers on the stage tonight, but there's a lot more to it than just those performers on the stage. There are crews that are behind the scenes that make it all happen. Our 10th award presenter is Chris Russo tonight, to present the award for Outstanding Stage Crew. Now, I think he knows a little bit about this. Chris Russo is associate producer for the Totem Pole Playhouse and instructor of scenic technology at Virginia Tech. Chris, it's a pleasure.
Twelve hours ago, Rowan said I'd be doing this, so I was not prepared for that. I do want to thank Majestic for providing their scenic crew to help us out this evening. They've been doing a great job, especially today with the rehearsal. It was quite an adventure to push through all that. I know that technical crews don't usually get the opportunity to take their bow on the stage, so I'm very pleased to be getting this award for all those people that never get a chance to take a bow. So, the nominees for the Outstanding Stage Crew, number one is Guys and Dolls, Bermudian Springs High School. Bye Bye Birdie, James Buchanan High School. Anything Goes, Lewiston High School. Reese, McCollinsburg High School. Damn Yankees, Waynesboro Area Senior High School. And the award for the Outstanding Stage Crew goes to Anything Goes.
Touch that I want to acknowledge. We have the final nominees for Best Duet from Anything Goes production at Littlestown High School. We have Owen Yingling and Alexis Anderson, and they're going to be singing Cole Porter's hit, It's the Lovely.
Skies why you're sentimental, cause so am I. It's delightful, it's delicious, it's lovely. You can tell at a glance what a swell night this is. For romance you can hear, dear love, and nature tremble. Let yourself go, so please be sweet, my chickadee. And when I kiss you, just say to me, it's delightful, it's delicious, it's delectable, it's delirious, it's dilemma, it's dilemma, it's the loss, it's the lovely.
I feel a sudden urge to sing the kind of ditty that invokes the spring. So control your desire to curse while I crucify the verse. This verse I've started seems to me the tympantithesis of melody. So to spare you all that pain, I'll skip the darn thing and sing the refrain. Me, 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 re, 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 do, so, re, do, la, si.
Our next presenter, because he's also our co-host tonight, Fred Snyder. Fred, going to be presenting for outstanding vocal duet. Thank you, Fred.
Yeah, there is someone there. I did this one time, and they gave me an envelope with a winner inside, and they didn't put the winner inside. So I always check. Outstanding vocal duet. These are our finalists. Matt Meckley and Fisher Selby. Guys and Dolls from Guys and Dolls. And we can explain how. Anna Zeischel and Sarah Steele. By My Side Godspell. Chambersburg Area Senior High School. Alexis Anderson and Owen Yingling, It's De Lovely from Anything Goes. Brittany Black and Drew Becker, You're the Top, Anything Goes. New Oxford. And Claire Martin and Ben Dennis, Two Lost Souls, Damn Yankees, Waynesboro Area Senior High. Hold on. Anna Zeischel. It was easy.
Jackie Arcanis.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Lily. Where's my sidekick?
There
he is.
I needed a kick in the side, apparently.
All right. I tell you what, we've got some more talent here.
We have the last two production numbers. This is, I'm telling you, we're running like clockwork here tonight, I'm happy to say. Which is amazing, considering all the applause in between. That's great. Thank you for that. The next production number is by Mercersburg Academy. It's from Legally Blonde, and it's entitled So Much Better, Mercersburg Academy.
Better.
Ha!
production number. New Oxford High School, Blow Gabriel Blow from Anything Goes.
You sinners, you're all too full of expense.
Totem Pole to do Anything Goes somewhere in the near future. And whoever's recording this, can you save me a copy? If we do it, I'd like to steal some of this stuff. Amazing production numbers from amazing productions from some amazing students. And again, it's the obstacles when you're doing a high school musical, it really is a thankless job in a lot of ways. It's not the kind of thing that you usually get the spotlight shown on you, which we're very happy to be able to do with the Totem Pole Awards this year and every year to come. It's the thing that we're really happy about is seeing these students get the acknowledgement they so rightly deserve and having the audiences thank you. You know, the audience's parents and other folks that came out to see the show tonight, we greatly appreciate it because without you, none of us would be able to do what it is that we do do. And we're very happy to introduce you to do. Ah, you kids. That's good, an easy crowd. I wish I'd known. Now you let me know. I had a lot more bad jokes I could have brought in a lot earlier. All right, well, good. I'm glad I waited until the end. So I want to thank those members of the general public who come out and support Totem Pole Playhouse especially, but also who come out in each of these communities and support their children. I hope tonight when you go home, you'll tell all of your friends and your neighbors and other people in your communities just how wonderful the talent pool is here, how wonderful high school musicals are in Adams, Franklin, and Fulton County, and let's keep building those numbers of audiences that come out and see these. And speaking of terrific local theater, Thursday night I had the time of my life. I was able to go to the Capitol Theater, our sister theater over in Chambersburg, and I was able to see a wonderful production of one of my favorite shows, Peter Pan, which I remember, those of you who are old enough or a certain age would remember Mary Martin playing Peter in black and white and then color. And when I was a kid, basically we would watch that. It was one of my first introductions to theater. I remember afterwards all of my sister, my brother, and I going upstairs and jumping off our beds and trying to fly. It's a terrific musical, and Chambersburg Community Theater did a brilliant job and reminded us not only of the magic of Peter Pan, but of the magic of theater. And Chambersburg Community Theater is there 9 months of the year. Totem Pole is there 3 months of the year. And we're so happy to have them as our partners in presenting theater over in the Chambersburg area, as well as here in Gettysburg with the wonderful Gettysburg Community Theater. This year, Totem Pole, there was a tradition that existed. Those of you who live around here probably know this. It was one of the things I found out when I first took my job at Totem Pole was that for many, many, many years, year after year after year after year, as a matter of fact, one of the things that really helped introduce children in the area to theater for the first time was a production Totem Pole used to do of A Christmas Carol that was an annual tradition over at the Capitol Theater. And I'm very happy to say it will be returning this year to the Capitol Theater over in Chambersburg, and it will be co-produced with Totem Pole Playhouse in association with the Chambersburg Community Theater. Happy to announce that next year, apparently we were so good, Santa's giving us a heads up already of the gift that we're going to get in 2015, because in 2015 we're going to be doing the Christmas Carol with Chambersburg Community Theater over in Chambersburg at the Capitol Theater, and joining us in 2015 will be Gettysburg Community Theater, and it will also be presented here on stage at the Majestic. Tradition here with the Totem Pole Awards. We hope to create a new tradition both in Chambersburg and Gettysburg, both at the Capitol Theater and the beautiful Gettysburg College Majestic Theater, by presenting our production jointly created with Gettysburg Community Theater and Chambersburg Community Theater and Totem Pole Playhouse every year for the foreseeable future. Christmas Carol will be here, and you'll all be able to come out and enjoy that. That's being made possible, in addition to Chad Allen Carr, who's been our terrific director and helping run everything tonight, the other team that is helping us put that together are the folks from Chambersburg Community Theater,
The executive director, Sally Herrett, and the president, Tom Trovac, are both here tonight. They're going to be presenting the award for outstanding musical production number. My friends, my partners in theater over there in Franklin County, Sally and Tom.
To say Turgovac. Sorry. It's a good Irish name. You know, what an honor to be up here today. I tell you, I'm just so glad that we're not having to make this decision, because after watching these performances, boy, that would be a tough call to make, because you guys were wonderful.
I
want to
be back in high school.
Yeah. And while I'm up here, you know, I would be remiss if I didn't say, you know, when you're done with your high school shows, or if you want to, while you're still in high school, if you want to try your hand at a regional theater like Chambersburg Community Theater, please, you know, audition for our shows. We draw talent from the tri-state region, so all the high schools that are here, everyone here is eligible to audition for our shows. We would really love to have some of this talent on stage. So please, when you see the auditions, come out and give us a try. We're not just a Chambersburg theater, we really are a regional base. We just happen to be located there. And we have a lovely theater like this to perform our shows in, so please.
And all of that being said, now the nominees for Outstanding Musical Production Number, Something New from High School Musical, Forbes Road Junior Senior High School. Anything Goes from Anything Goes, Littlestown High School. Born to Hand Jive from Greece, McConnellsburg High School. Blow Gabriel Blow from Anything Goes. And Heart from Damn Yankees, Waynesboro Area Senior High School.
And the Totem Pole Award goes to Anything Goes for what kind of school? Millstown High School.
Performance by an actress in a leading role, and also outstanding performance by an actor in a leading role. Our presenter is Chad Allen Carr. Now, he is founding executive artistic director at Gettysburg Community Theater right here on York Street in Gettysburg. He does an outstanding job with this theater. And he's been behind the scenes tonight. He reminds me of the Energizer Bunny running from one end of the stage to the other and making sure all the performances came off perfectly. I want to bring him in right now, Chad Allen Carr.
Thank you.
take it by yourself, I insist. Whatever you
Thank you. It was my freshman year in high school, just a few years ago. Why are you laughing? The show was Your Good Man Charlie Brown. Having already played the title role, I knew I would be a shoo-in. I was cast as the male understudy. It's okay. The moral of the story is don't give up. Audition, audition, audition. You're not always going to get the part. You're not always going to get the job you interviewed for. Now I run my own theater, 15 musicals a year. So keep going. Follow your dreams. It's like that show Les Mis Blah. Jean Valjean steals a loaf of bread, and then he suffers for the rest of his life for it. For toast. Get over it. Announcing the outstanding performance by an actress in a leading role, nominees are Caitlin Crawford, Adelaide, Guys and Dolls, Bermudian Springs High School. Sierra Kelly, Rose Alvarez, Bye Bye Birdie, James Buchanan High School. Caitlin Tremens, Elle Woods, Legally Blonde, Mercy. Reno Sweeney, Anything Goes, New Oxford High School. Claire Martins, Lola, Damn Yankees, Waynesboro Area High School. And the winner is... for the outstanding performance, for an actress, one of the shows that I just mentioned. It's a while to open that envelope. The winner is Caitlin Crimes, Elle Wood. The next nominees are Outstanding Performance by an Actor in a Leading Role, Jensen Fleet, Jesus, Godspell, Kyle Schoen, Troy Bolton, High School Musical, Four Pro Junior Senior High, Owen Yingling, Billy Crocker, Anything Goes, Littlestown. Anything Goes, New Oxford High School. And Ben Dennis, Applegate, Damn Yankees, Waynesboro Area High School. And the winner is, for Outstanding Performance by an Actor in a Leading Role, Ben Dennis.
I am really, really, really honored and humbled to be up here in such great company full of actors and actresses from around Franklin, Fulton, and Adams County. I think everyone deserves a huge round of applause because that was fantastic. Because I'm chewing gum on stage, but I'm gonna keep chewing it anyway. Speaking of Mrs. Holland, Mrs. Holland is... You're such an inspiration to everyone in the Waynesboro School District for all your hard work and dedication over the past 20 plus years as director, so we love you very much. Thank you. The cast of Damn Yankees, Gurf Squad. Thank you, Griff. To Sue, our awesome set designer and constructor, we thank you. And to everyone in the cast of Damn Yankees, I couldn't have done this without everyone, and I have to thank my parents and my family, who all are here. Thank you, guys. And I have to give a huge shout out to my co-star, Claire Martin. We've been acting together since the fourth grade in Waynesboro Children's Theater Troupe, and this is finally the first show we were co-stars together, and we got to have a duet on stage, so thank you. You're awesome. Thank you for coming to the Majestic Theater for hosting this, and the cast of Damn Yankees and Mrs. Holland, this one's for you. Thank you, guys.
We still have a few more awards to give out. Our next presenter. Oh, I forgot his bio. Wait a minute, it's Rowan Joseph, artistic director at the Totem Pole Playhouse. What a pleasure it is having worked with him for just a short time that I have. He's here to present the Gene Stapleton Award for outstanding contribution to a high school musical. Let me bring you in right now, Rowan Joseph. And you know when I first saw Rowan Joseph? You know he is the queen of bingo. It was a production, an outstanding production. And I think you own the rights to that now, don't you?
We do. Well, we don't own the rights, but we have the rights to tour it as men playing the two sisters, the two bingo, crazy bingo sisters.
Give them a bingo.
Yeah. Bingo!
There you go.
The funny part of the Queen of Bingo is another part of the crazy life that I live that some people here are sort of aware of. I know at Totem Pole they are, which is, in addition to running Totem Pole Playhouse, I run Theater Go-Go, which is a national touring production company that does equity shows around the country, including the Queen of Bingo, which I have been touring in for, I've been touring in it for 8 years. Shane, my best friend and the co-owner of the company with me, he's been touring in it for 10 years. And we run around the country, literally all over, 29 states so far, playing these crazy bingo sisters, and just have the best time doing it. And boy, I'll tell you, getting in, you know, the whole stuff that you have to get in as a woman really makes you appreciate women a lot more. Men should have to walk a mile in a lady's heels, let me tell you. And the other upshot of all of that was, because it's such an unusual thing, we ended up in an unusual place. I ended up not too long ago hanging off the side of a mountain in Chile, because Shane and I were two of the contestants this last year on The Amazing Race on CBS. So that was fun. Second round, and we were gone, but we're better bingo than apparently we are racing around the world. But we had a great time and really appreciated having that opportunity. I want to talk for a moment, those of you who aren't aware of the history of Totem Pole Playhouse. There's a gentleman, it was started by Carl Jenis. Carl Jenis opened Totem Pole Playhouse back in 1951, 52. Carl then went on, at the time that he was running the Summerstock Theater over there at Caledonia State Park, and at that point it was a dance hall up on top of the mountain where everyone would, they'd climb up the top of this big tall mountain and they'd sit on benches and they'd bring their own cushions. And Carl was also a very well-known television director at the time, in the 50s and the early days, the golden age of television as they refer to it, and rightly so.
And Carl went on to become the Vice President of the Directors Guild of America, the DGA, which is a very powerful union in Hollywood. And he served as the Vice President for 24 years. And he's the founder of Totem Pole Playhouse. Coming after him and running Totem Pole Playhouse for 30 years was a gentleman who was very much my idol, Bill Punch. I was your age, I had just graduated high school, and decided I wanted to go into the theater. And I lived in Berks County in Reading, not too terribly far from here, about 2 hours, I guess, away. And one of my neighbors happened to know Bill Punch and his wife, Jean Stapleton. And they asked Bill if I could come up and meet him and if he could give me some advice as an actor starting out his career. And I came up in my little sport coat, my tie, and I thought, well, this is so amazing. I'm going to go and get to meet Bill Punch and find out about theater. And I assumed, and correctly so in that assumption, that, you know, I would spend 5-10 minutes with him and, you know, have this great experience. And I came to Totem Pole Playhouse back in 1974, and Bill Punch took 2 hours of his time to walk me through every corner of that theater, to walk me through the dress shop and explain how that worked and operated, and the props, and the myriad of props all over the place, and how that worked, and the importance of props, as well as the scene shop. And we ended up on the stage a little bit, but where we really ended up was the box office, and his office was just off of that. And he explained to me the importance of theater really starts with that front line, with that box office, because it's the audience that allows us to do what it is we love to do. He then showed me the levelers, I think they were called, these big things that open up on the side of the theater. I never forgot to let the air go through. Now we have air conditioning. But it really, it had such a major, major effect on my life. I mean, I did go into theater. He told me what to expect. He told me what it was going to be like living in New York, not just what it was going to be like as an actor, but what it was going to be like as someone living in New York and struggling. Interestingly enough, I never did get to work at that time at Totem Pole Playhouse. It is still a union company, a union theater and actors equity union. And when I finally got my card, I was so excited because the great thing about Bill was not only did he take that time, but every now and then I would get a note from him asking how I was doing and where I was in my career and how things were going. And he kind of stayed in touch with me a little bit, which I so appreciated. And I was so excited when I got my equity card that I could finally audition for Totem Pole Playhouse. And I said, "Is what I'm going to Totem Pole?" And they said, "Oh, it's a wonderful, wonderful place to work, but don't bother auditioning." I was like, "Well, not that bad. I mean, come on." They explained at the time, Totem Pole used to be what was under what's called the course contract. So they would hire a company of actors who would be there all summer long, and one or two jobbers would come in. And if you got into the company of actors, you were there. As many of the actors at Totem Pole have been for 10, 20, even 30 or more years. This year we switched things around and we're under a coast contract at Totem Pole, which basically means that each individual production is separately cast. And so we have an amazing collection of people coming in. We're opening Steel Magnolias with Melissa Gilbert. We're very happy to have her here and some wonderful talented actresses from both New York and Washington coming in with that cast, as well as Catherine Blaine, who's been working at Totem Pole. I think this is her 25th show there, so we're keeping that tradition alive as well. Following Steel Magnolias is Ring of Fire, the music of Johnny Cash. Some of the most amazing country western players, some of the top players are coming in, including really what many people consider to be the world's best fiddler, Bradley Kearns. Bradley lives in Los Angeles. He only plays a couple shows a year. He's coming to Totem Pole, to the forest, believe it or not, and he's going to be playing in Johnny Cash, Ring of Fire. Directing that and starring in the show is Jason Edwards, who appeared on the Broadway production of Ring of Fire. Joining him will be Johnny Kennard, who was recently in Million Dollar Quartet on Broadway for 3 years. Allison Brenner, who just left Mamma Mia on Broadway, and Trenna Barnes. So some amazing talent. Jeff Linsby is the musical director. He's worked with everyone from Blake Shelton to Lee Greenwood to Dolly Parton. So it's really an amazing cast. Following that show, we have The Foreigner. The Foreigner is a very funny farce, and it's being directed by a gentleman named Ken Jenkins, who many of you will know as Dr. Kelso from Scrubs. He was the crazy older hospital administrator on Scrubs. I know a show that a lot of young people watched and enjoyed it. And it's an interesting story about Ken, because while he's very well known as Dr. Kelso from Scrubs. And currently, by the way, he's on Cougar Town. He plays Courtney Cox's father on Cougar Town. But in the theater, Ken is best known to us as one of the three gentlemen who founded the Actors Theater of Louisville, one of the most famous, prestigious Lord theaters in the country. And Ken is one of the people who founded that. And it's very interesting to me because when Melissa came in to rehearsals last week, her husband, Tim Busfield, drove her in and came in. Tim, you would know from Field of Dreams, if you recall that movie, he's the bad guy in there, the evil brother who wants to sell the cornfield and plow it all down. And Tim was also on 30-something and West Wing and appears in a lot of stuff now. And Tim walked outside and said, Ken Jenkins is coming, Ken Jenkins. And I said, yeah, he said, Ken Jenkins. He goes, Ken Jenkins is going to be here the same stage that my wife is on. I said, well, your wife's on the stage first, you know. You might want to get excited about that. But he explained, he said, you don't understand. I have my career because of Ken Jenkins. I was a young actor, an intern at Actors Theater of Louisville, and I was doing a scene with Ken Jenkins, and he stopped me and he says, you're awful. And he said, I was awful. And I said to him, I know I'm awful. Teach me. And Ken did teach him. And he became a terrific actor who works all the time. He also works as a director and a producer. And Tim is a recurring role on Sleepy Hollow. And as you've seen from his work on 30-something and West Wing and other movies that he's in, he's a terrific actor. And that's what theater's about. It is that mentorship, just as Bill Punch helped to mentor me. Years later, when I came to Totem Pole to do the Queen of Bingo, it was because of my relationship with Bill. And that circle was completed. Ken is coming in and doing The Foreigner, and starring in it with him is a terrific actor named Dan Jenkins. Dan is a two-time Tony Award nominee, Big River, those of you who've done the musical Big River. Dan was the original Huck in Big River. Dan is also Ken's son, so that's kind of neat. Adding to the neatness, Jesse Jenkins, Dan's son, is playing Ellard. So we have three generations of the Jenkins family, one of the great American theater families, on stage together in Totem Pole in The Foreigner. Joining them in the role of Catherine is a woman named Catherine, ironically. Catherine Heller, that's her stage name. Her married name is Jenkins. Also, wonderful Broadway actress, Jesse's mom, Ken's daughter-in-law, Dan's wife. Harris Pete, who is the head of the theater department in Shippensburg, he's also in the show. He's not related to anyone in the show. And Corey Grill, also not related. He's coming in from Los Angeles, has appeared at Actors Theater of Louisville, appeared on Broadway in numerous shows, so he's coming in. And then filling out the cast is this wonderful, wonderful actress, Jill Larson. There's a viral video going around of complete strangers kissing each other. Maybe you've seen it. It's all the rage. Well, Jill is one of those strangers, complete strangers. She's actually not a complete stranger to many women who watch soap operas because Jill has been on All My Children for 22 years. And she's a terrific actress. She's also an ordained minister in real life, and she married Dan and Catherine in real life. So I say it's the Jenkins family singers that are coming in to The Foreigner. Hopefully you'll come out and see that. And the last show of the season is Godspell, with the wonderful cast of actors that we're bringing in. Gene Stapleton was very much the, I guess you could say, she certainly was the soul, in many ways, of Totem Pole Playhouse. But Bill Punch was definitely its heart. Jean was a wonderful, gifted actress, started out on Broadway as a character actress and became a star, certainly is best known for her role in All the Families, Edith Bunker. And we wanted to honor her. We only have two named awards in the whole evening, the Jean Stapleton Award, and then later the last award that we'll give out, the Carl Schurr Award, which is named after the gentleman who followed Bill and ran Totem Pole Playhouse for 25 years. The Gene Stapleton Award is something that we came up with when we were putting everything together and talking to the directors. We basically wanted to have an award that we would be able to acknowledge someone from each and every high school participating in the Totem Pole Awards for their contribution to their individual high school. In many instances, the judges made recommendations and the directors went, that's who I was going to pick, that's great. In some instances, they said, the judges said, we're not totally certain, and the directors made some suggestions. And we have a long list of people here that we're going to be giving the Gene Stapleton Award to. The award is going to individuals from each of these high schools whose contributions were considered by those at those high schools to be invaluable to the production that they put up on stage. Tom, I'm going to make up for butchering your name by now butchering an entire list of names. So, you'll be in good company. I'm going to ask, as I announce your name, please come up on stage. Julie is going to be presenting you with your Totem Pole Award, and unfortunately, because of time, we don't have time for a lot of speeches. There are an enormous amount of winners, which is great, but we want to give everyone their award and then do a group bow and get a group photo, and then we'll move on to our final award of the evening, and we'll wrap this all up. From Bermudian Springs High School, the winner of the Gene Stapleton Outstanding Contribution to a High School Musical Award is Logan Althoff. Logan? From Chambersburg Area Senior High School, the winners are Cricket Francesco and Maggie Malott. From Forbes Road Junior Senior High School, the winners are David Malinato, Hallie Lashinsky, Faith Kennedy, and Courtney Schoen. From Gettysburg Area High School, the winner of the Gene Stapleton Award for Outstanding Contribution to a High School Musical is Antonio Rinaldi. From Greencastle Atrium High School, the winner is Skylar Allen. From James Buchanan High School, the winner is Luke Lighty. Littlestown High School, there are two winners from Littlestown, Alexis Saggy and Emily Thomas. The Cottlesburg High School, not to be outdone, has five winners. Ashton Doyle, Aaron Strait, Austin Shelley, Cody Parsons, Bryce Stately. And I want you five guys to know that we, when we said to the judge, the teacher of the school said, so it only goes to one, and we said, you know what, when it comes to your school, we'd like to give it to five, because those five guys at Grease Lightning, they were awesome. Mercersburg Academy, the nominee, and now the winner of the Gene Stapleton Award, Kay Kistler and Alex Jackson. New Oxford High School, Ryan Scallon is being presented with the Gene Stapleton Award for Outstanding Contribution to a High School Musical. And finally, from Waynesboro Area High School, Sophie Black and Courtney Spradlin. Now you see what I mean about it would have been a lot of speeches. We'd have been here a little longer. So I want to, on behalf of your directors, your musical directors, your fellow cast members, your stage crew and other folks, you are the folks who really, really inspire me the most. I mean, I'm inspired by all of the performers, but it's folks like you who really go the extra mile, who put in the extra time, and in a lot of instances, move over, can you let them know, make sure they see you. In a lot of instances, you weren't even putting in extra time on yourself, you were putting it in on other cast members and helping out with scenery and costumes and props and other stuff. And that's really what theater's about. You know, as Tom and Sally know and Chad knows, theater to us is something that's invaluable in our lives. And whether you go forward and you do it as a career, or you go forward and you use those skills as a lawyer, or a doctor, or in a job interview, I often laugh because I know sports, and again, I have nothing against sports, I think they're wonderful, but the irony to me is always that being a quarterback or being part of a team is no different than being in a cast. It's very, very much the same. You are very dependent on the other people that are up there. One of the things that is different is the skill set that you learn doing High School Musical theaters, I can assure you, will serve you many times throughout your life in many, many different situations. It is an invaluable, invaluable resource to have, and you are all invaluable to each of your high schools and your community. Thank you.
Okay. We're a little behind time, but not so bad. We had one slight change, and I apologize that it didn't work out. Our next presenter is the director of Steel Magnolias, and a friend now of mine. I mean, we've worked together, this is the second time we've worked together. I ran the Fulton Theater in Los Angeles for Gary Marshall, hence the kind donation that Gary made for the Totem Pole Awards. Skip directed a show while I was at the Fulton that had one of the most amazing casts of actors. Jack Klugman, one of my dear friends, Charlie Durning, Paul Dooley, and Granville Van Dusen. It was about 300, almost 400 years of acting talent up there on that stage. And one of those actors, Granville Van Dusen, Sonny, will be here playing Abraham Lincoln next year at the Majestic as part of a co-production with Totem Pole and the Majestic Theater. So you'll see how everything that we do at Totem Pole is connected to you, to the community. And my job is to introduce as many different people as I can from Hollywood and New York and Nashville and everywhere else to this amazing, amazing community, and then also likewise to hope that you will come out and introduce them yourselves to the community by attending our shows. The next presenter to present the Carl Schurr Award for Outstanding Production of a High School Musical, and you know, I don't do this, but I'm gonna in this case, because it was just the point spread between these five contestants was unbelievable. The top three, less than 1 point. In adding up the points between all of it. As you can tell, you see how difficult it is to judge this, and so many different factors go into it. As far as I'm concerned, the shows are all winners, you're all great, and we really appreciate the talent, but I wanted you to know it's a real compliment, I think, to the high schools, particularly these five schools, that it was as close and as tight as it was. To present the award for the Outstanding Production of a High School Musical is Skip Greer. Skip is the head of education at Jiva Theater. He has been a professional actor for, oh my God, how many years, Skip? 35 or something? 35 years, making a living at it. With a wife and children, I make a living. I have a dog, and I don't know how I can hardly keep the dog. So clearly a far better actor than I am. I know a far better director and a wonderful friend, Skip Greer.
You know, it's long been said that the purpose of theater is to resensitize, that we go out there, we walk around the streets, and we desensitize. We come back in here and we resensitize, and I gotta tell you, I don't think I've felt this resensitized in decades. What talent in here tonight. Really. You don't know me from Adam. I know that. I worked at the American Conservatory Theater, the Guthrie Theater, the Oregon Shakespeare Festival, major leading LORP theaters. I've been lucky enough to work with Academy Award winners, Emmy Award winners, Tony Award winners. None of that has anything compared to the future of the young actors that I've seen here tonight. Now, Melissa Gilbert was planning on being here tonight. She was going to stand next to me and present this award, but because of a family emergency, she couldn't make it tonight. But I know that she wanted to glimpse into the future like I have this evening. Carpe diem. The Carl Schurr Award for Outstanding Production of a Musical, Guys and Dolls, Bermudian Springs High. Godspell, Chambersburg Area Senior High School. Anything Goes, Littlestown High School. Anything Goes, New Oxford High School. And Damn Yankees, Waynesboro Area Senior High School. The show I'm directing for Totem Pole is Steel Magnolias. It's all about the community that forms in a beauty salon. This is an amazing community. I've been here for 3 days. I've never seen anything like this before. The winner is... I love that moment. Lesser Award for Outstanding Production of a Musical is Godspell.
There's a lot of wonderful theater here. There's some wonderful theater that will be going on this summer over in Caledonia Park. I want to thank Fred Snyder, our cohort here. Also, we are going to do pictures, and I know there are family members who want to do pictures, so I'm asking all of the award winners with your trophies, if you can, we're going to put the music on, the lights up, come back up here on stage so we can take some more pictures with you. Your family, if they're here, you want to take pictures up here, come on up. The Love Fest is over, but it'll be back again next year. Come out to Totem Pole.